friends, how are you all? Hope everybody is fine staying at their homes. In this video, we will be going to learn CBSE Class 9 Civics Chapter 2 Constitutional Design. In this lesson, we will be going to learn 7 subtopics: History of South Africa, Racial Discrimination in South Africa, Fights of the Blacks against Whites, Writing the Constitution of South Africa, Importance of Constitution, Writing of the Indian Constitution, Preamble and its Importance. History of South Africa. South Africa, known as the Rainbow Country, has various cultures and traditions with 11 official languages. South Africa is one recent instance of designing constitution for a democratic country. In 1795, Britishers have occupied South Africa. From 1795 to 1961, a racial discrimination of blacks by whites used to take place, which is commonly known as apartheid. Unlike India, Britishers didn't leave South Africa. Instead, they settled there permanently and became the local rulers. This system of apartheid divided the people into 3 different groups based on their colors: whites, blacks, and the colored. Racial discrimination. Blacks were very inferior to whites. Blacks were not allowed into the areas of whites until or unless they have a permission. There was a segregation for the public facilities to blacks and whites. They could not even visit the churches where whites worshipped. Even forming associations and protesting against the whites' treatment was not allowed. Agriculture and transportation was different to each other. When a white enters a bus or train, black must should offer his seat to the white.
Friends, do you think that the discrimination has still continued?
No. But how? Now, we shall see in the fights of blacks against the whites. From 1950, the blacks and the colored together fought against the whites. They started protests, marches, and did strikes. The newly formed party, along with many workers' unions and communist party, led to the struggle against the policies of segregation. There were also some whites who have supported and were kind towards blacks. Seeing the situation in South Africa, many countries denounced apartheid as injustice. But the British government didn't step down. Instead, it detained, tortured and killed many blacks and the colored. Now, seeing the more and more revolting of blacks, whites were fearing that they might lose the power. There was an increasement of fights in apartheid system, which made the whites' government to realize that they could no longer keep up the power against the blacks. As a result, the rules were changed, political parties were banned, and the policies were changed. After 28 years of a long period, Nelson Mandela was released from jail in 1992. Yet finally, of the midnight of 26th April 1994, everywhere was filled with happiness in South Africa. Therefore, South Africa became the Republic of South Africa. After the fight and the freedom, we need a set of rules for ruling the country. Therefore, our next topic is writing the Constitution of South Africa. South Africa was marked as a newly born democracy in the world. Finally, the apartheid system was over and multiracial government was started. After the independence, the blacks were asked to forgive by whites for their atrocities on blacks. So now the whites, along with the blacks, sat together and wrote their constitution. They had written their constitution such a way that equal rights were given to both blacks and whites. They had promised themselves to respect each other and do not perform any more atrocities. South Africa's constitution is one of the world's best constitutions. Here, we need to understand a point that constitution has developed a degree of trust between the whites and blacks. Now, we shall see the importance of the constitution. Constitution is a book of legal rules which should be followed by everyone, including the government, the rich man or the poor man. It is the supreme law of the country, containing the fundamental rules. Every person is equal before the law and the constitution. Nobody has the right to change the rules or rewrite the constitution. A constitution does the following. It generates a degree of trust between people, cities, states and countries. It specifies how the government should function and what power is a person having. It puts down limits on the powers of government and tells us what are the rights of the citizens. It expresses the hankerings of the people about maintaining a good environment. Writing of the Indian Constitution. In 1920, Mahatma Gandhi started a movement known as Non-Cooperation Movement. It means that no Indian will support Britishers. So, Gandhi asked all the Indians to stop working for Britishers. If Indians were not working, the Britishers had no income. In order to gain themselves, Britishers have raised fights against themselves and India. While the Indians were protesting against the Britishers, the Britishers used to kick the Indians with their boots. By doing so, Indians lost their patience and killed some of the polices and fired the vehicles and some of the police stations. Due to such many problems, Gandhiji had to stop the movement. But again in 1930, Gandhiji, without losing his spirit, launched a huge movement named Quit India Movement. It had took 12 years for Gandhiji to train the Indians in calm and peace way. This time, the revolt was huge and more. At the same time, the Muslim League had started another movement. Two movements at a time were very difficult for Britishers to control it. Finally, in 1945, Britishers have promised that they would leave India by dividing India and Pakistan into two different countries. So, in 1946, there was a matter of writing constitution. So, all our heroes, the freedom fighters, formed the Constituent Assembly. The strength of the Constituent Assembly was 299 members. All these 299 members were of forward caste, lower caste and different religions. They all are the part of the constitution. All the 299 members were elected by the 12 provincial states belonging to different caste, language and religion. So, all the 299 members sat together and started the discussion of setting the rules. One person says one rule and another person says another rule. Like this, it went on and finally 20 to 19 books of rules were prepared. But all the 20 books cannot be the constitution. So, six members from the 299 members formed a committee known as the Drafting Committee. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the head of this committee. The work of this drafting committee was to correct the rules. These six members of the committee had traveled and read different constitutions like the American, Canadian, French, Australian and Russian constitutions and added some important points. On total, 2000 articles were selected. After the debate and discussion of the Constituent Assembly, 395 articles were finalized. From the period of 1946 to the period of 1949, 3 years has been taken by the Constituent Assembly to write the Constitution. Finally, on 26 January 1950, we have celebrated our Republic Day, where each and every person got their freedom.
But how could they all write the constitution easily compared to South Africa?
In 1928, Motilal Nehru, father of Jawaharlal Nehru, along with 8 Congress leaders, wrote a constitution for India and kept it aside. In 1931, in Karachi Congress session, all the leaders discussed that after independence, how will we write our constitution? How should it be? In order to overcome this problem, the Karachi Congress session people had drafted a sample constitution. In 1935, Britishers have passed a rule, the 1935 Act. Britishers along with some Indians together have written a constitution that time for ruling. So finally, these three constitutions were equated together, and 1/4 of the Indian constitutions was written from these three. Remaining 3/4 of the constitution was written by observing other countries' constitution.
India is the only country where constitution is tabled and written only once. Till now, nobody has changed it. No one could change it because it is written in such perfect way that nobody can prove that some point is wrong in the constitution. There is no right to anybody to change the Indian constitution.
Every book has an index to show its main idea. Our constitution also has an index to show the main ideals of the constitution. Therefore, the index of the constitution is known as the preamble. It is also known as the face of the constitution. Preamble is an introductory statement of a constitution which resembles the features of a constitution.
But why do we need to accept the constitution?
We need and have to accept the constitution because the members of the Constitutional Assembly, even though not elected directly, they represent different castes, religions, languages and cultures. And all provisions in the Constitution reflect upon the castes, religion, languages and cultures. Now, we shall have a look at the Indian preamble.
We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
The four main ideals enshrined in the preamble are justice. Citizens cannot be discriminated on the grounds of caste, religion and gender. Liberty. There are no unreasonable restrictions on the citizens in what they think, how they wish to express their thoughts and the way they wish to follow up their thoughts in action. Equality. All are equal before the law. Fraternity. All of us should behave as if we are the members of the same family.
Friends, hope you liked the video. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe Ganesh Study Rankers.